This conference will now be recorded.
Let's start. Hope it's audible to everyone. Okay, so in the last class, we have seen how to create search help. We understood that we have two types of search help: elementary search help and collective search help. Elementary search help will provide only one input path, whereas collective search help will provide multiple input paths. Okay, so when you are creating the elementary search help, we have to provide selection method. Okay, when you are creating the elementary search help, we need to provide the selection method. Selection method, we understood that it can be a database table or a database view or help view. Okay, database view database view or help view. And we understood that database view will follow inner join, and help view will follow left outer join. Okay, and we have seen how to use the search help. We can attach the search help at the data element level. Okay, and we can attach the search help at selection screen input field level, and we can attach the search help to the transaction input field. So we don't know how to design this transaction. We'll see it now. Okay, so when do we go for attaching the search help to the data element? Okay, if you want to use that search help globally, means wherever that particular data element is referred, in all the places, if you want that search help, if you want that F4 values, we will attach that search help to the data element level. If that requirement is specific to a particular report, then we'll do it at selection screen input level, input field level. How do we do it in selection screen input field level? Last class we have seen, we have to use one option. What is that addition? Match code object. Okay, as part of parameter statement, you have to say match code object. This is what you'll say. Okay, now what I'll do is, I will design one transaction. Try to understand. I'll design one transaction. Okay, so what is a transaction? A transaction is a collection of one or more screens. Okay, so in this case, I'll take only one screen. And what is the table we have created last class? If you go to SC11, what is the table we have created? ZABAP_team. So it has got some fields like MANDT, employee ID, and employee name. So what I'll do is, I'll take these three fields: client field, employee ID, and I'll take employee name. Okay, employee ID, and then employee name. So I'll take this. So this is my transaction, which contains three fields: employee ID and employee name. My voice is breaking. Is my voice is not clear? Hello? Yeah, others, can you please respond? Is my voice is clear or not clear? Srikant, it's clear. Clear. Raghavendra, just re-log in. Re-login. If you have any issues, just re-login, because for the others it's clear, it seems. Okay, just re-login if you have any problem. Right, employee ID, and employee name. Employee name. So my requirement is here, I want to design this transaction. Okay, I want some validations here. Try to understand. I want some validations. What are the validations here? Client field should be disabled. Client field should be disabled. And then for employee ID, associate a custom search help. So what we are trying to understand is how to attach the search help to your transaction field. That is what is our agenda, but we don't know how to design this transaction. We will see now. Okay, so this is nothing but module pull programming. So I'll just give the introduction of module programming and we'll try to design this particular trans. This is my overall requirement, and my transaction should contain what? One button, like what? Exit button. Okay, so when I click on that button, it should come out of the program. So this is my overall requirement. Okay, so let's see how to design this particular transaction. So for designing these transactions, we use what? Screen Painter. Okay, for designing transactions, we use a tool called as what? Screen Painter tool. Screen Painter tool, nothing but what? SE51. Okay, so by using this Screen Painter tool, we can design what? New transactions, new screens. Okay, right. So let me design it. So just try to understand the process. So what is the tool we have to use? SE51. That is Screen Painter tool. So initially I will not go directly to SE51. Okay, let me go to SE51. Let's see what happens. I'll go to SE51. Try to understand. I'm going to SE51. It will launch me what? Screen Painter tool. It is asking me the program name. Okay, so I'll give the program name as Z. Okay, I'll give the program name as Z. I'll give the program name as something Z. Test MPP, some program name I am giving, Z test module program. It is asking the screen number. Now, why it is asking the screen number? If it is a report program, and in your report program, if you have a selection screen, always the selection screen number is 1000. Always the selection screen number is what? 1000. Similarly, when you design the transactions, a transaction might contain what? One or more screens. Every screen should be uniquely identified. So assume that this screen number is 100. This screen number is something 200. This screen number is something what? 300. A transaction can contain n number of screens, and every screen should have what? Screen number. Okay. So what I'll do here? I'll try to give a screen number as what? 100. Screen number can be any number from 1 to 9,999. So I'm giving 100. I'll click on create. See here, when I click on create, it is giving me an error message saying that program so and so does not exist. So what I did here, directly I went to Screen Painter SC51. In that program, in that Screen Painter tool, I am trying to give a Z program and I am trying to provide some screen number. When I try to create, it is saying that program so and so does not exist. So we should not directly create like this. What you have to do is go to Object Navigator. Go to Object Navigator, SC80. Already we have seen the use of SC80. We have used it for creating what? Packages. Sorry. I think package I have not yet covered for you, for creating what? Function group. For creating the function group. So I'll go to SE80. Raghavendra, is it clear now? Voice?
Yes, sir, it's clear. It's so clear.
Fine. Done. So I came to what? Object Navigator, SE80. Right? So in this SE80, I repeat once again. I'll go to SE80, Object Navigator. Here it is asking me, what type of object you want to develop. I want to develop what? A transaction. Transaction, how do we, nothing but what? A module pool program, dialog programming. So whenever we create any module pool programming in this SC80, choose what? Program, and provide your program name. I'll give the program name as Z test MPP. I don't know whether this program is available or not. Press enter. When you press enter, if the program is available, it will display that. Otherwise, it will ask you to create that. So let me press enter. Program Z test MPP does not exist. Create the object. Understood? This program is not available, it seems. It is asking to create the object. I'll say yes. Done. So this is important again. Just see here. Whenever I'm trying to create a module pool program, it will ask you whether you want to create this program with what? top include program or without top include program. Already we know about top include program. Already we know about what top include program. When where we have seen that when you have when you create any function group, SAP will automatically create two include programs. One of the include program will end with what top. Okay, and I said that we can use the top include program for declaring global variables, for defining subroutine definitions, for defining modules, all those things. So here also, it is always better we create the module put program with top include. So let me select the checkbox what top include. So what I can do with this top include, I can do the global declarations. Whatever I declared in the top include program, those declarations can be used by what? All the screens of that particular program can be used by all the screens of that particular program. So here I'll say create with top include. So I'm selecting the checkbox. Create with top include, continue. It is asking me the name of the top include program. Always the top include program must end with what? Top, must end with the top. So remove the stars and give any name, start with Z or Y. So I'll give it as something Z. What is the program name? Test MPP. So here also I'll give it as Z test MPP. Okay, start with the Z, end with the top. In between you can give any name. Okay, so I gave it as Z test MPP top, continue. When I continue, yeah, it is asking the type of program, type of program. So far we were choosing the type of program as executable program, or we have choose the type of program as what include program. Now I'll choose the type of program as what module pool, save it. Okay, let me save it in the local object. Done. Okay, so here what I'll do is if I expand my module program, you can see it is showing me what the top include program. As of now it is empty. When I double click on this, yeah, it is showing it as what empty. Fine, I'll use it later on. So what is my requirement now? In this module program, I have to create a screen, right? So for creating, designing the screens, what is the tool we use? Screen Painter tool. So for to open that Screen Painter tool, right click on the program, right click on the program, create what screen, right click on the program and say create a screen. So when I say create screen, it is asking the screen number. Okay, let me give the screen number as 100. Any number you can give, I am giving it as 100. Any number from 1 to 9999. So I'll give it as 100. Continue. Done. So you can see here it has opened what? Screen Painter tool. Okay. So in the Screen Painter tool, attributes tab is there, element list is there, and flow logic. In the attributes tab, it is asking the description. I'll give some description. Let me give it as something screen 100. Then it is asking the type of screen, whether you want a normal screen or a subscreen or a model dialog box. So we'll be seeing all these three types of screens going forward. As of now, why we went for module put program is to attach our search help. Okay, so done. So I'll choose a screen type as what? Normal screen only. So in the attributes tab, just you have to give the description and choose a screen type. By default it is normal screen, let it be normal. I have to design the screen now. So on the application toolbar you can see we have a button what layout, layout button. So when I click on the layout button, it is opening me the Screen Painter layout. Right, so this is my Screen Painter tool. Okay, this is my Screen Painter tool. So what is my requirement here? I require what? Some three input fields. I require some three IO fields. I require some button. So you can see on the Screen Painter tool left hand side, we have a toolbox. Okay, we have a toolbox. Okay, so I want input field now. So you can see left hand side we have IO field, input output field. How to draw now? Click on this and draw here. Click and draw. Again, click, again, draw. Click and draw. I got three input fields. I want text fields now. So I can see we have text field. I'll just choose this. I'll design the text fields. Done. Done. So what I did here, I created three text fields. I created three IO fields. Done. For these text fields, I need to set some properties now. So just like if you take our selection screen, what you'll do, you'll say parameters. You'll have some name now. P underscore EMPID type so and so so and so. Done. Okay. So what is the name of that field? P underscore EMPID. Similarly, in screen painter also, every control, every element, every screen element should contain some name. So how do we set that properties here? If I double click on this, I'll double click on the first text field. When I double click on this, good. You can see when I double click on this, we are having what? Screen painter here. It is asking the name. It is asking the name. You can give any name. I'll get as what? T1, something T1. Text. What is the text I want? I want to give the text as what? Client. Done. I'll close the property window. Again, for this also I want. I'll double click on this. Name, I'll get as some name T2. I'll give the text as what? Employee ID. Whatever I want, I can give it. Like this, we need to set the properties for the fields. But my requirement is what? These fields should come from dictionary. These fields should come from a database structure, database table. So since I need to refer to the database, instead of we designing it manually, instead of we setting the properties, I can design the screen directly by referring to a database structure. So let me remove this. How do you remove this? Just click on this and press delete button. Select and delete. Select and delete. Done. So my requirement is I want three fields. These three fields are part of which table? Are part of what? ZABAP underscore team table. So how do you design the database fields? Here. Choose the menu, go to. Choose the menu, go to. Secondary window. Dictionary slash program fields. Okay. Okay. Choose the menu, go to. Secondary window. Dictionary slash program field. So when do we go for this navigation? Whenever you want to design the screen elements referring to the dictionary, referring to the database fields, then you have to follow this particular navigation. So I'll choose go to menu, secondary window, dictionary slash program fields. When I click on this, done. It is asking table slash field name. What is my table name? What is my table name? ZABAP underscore what? Team. ZABAP underscore team. This is my table name. I can give database table name here, or I can give a structure name here. A table or what? Structure. Okay, done. So now I can press enter. If I press enter, I'll get the fields here, or else there is a button here right hand side, get from dictionary. Get from dictionary. I can press enter or click on the button, get from dictionary. So when I click on this, done. It is showing me how many fields? Three fields. Table name is so-and-so, field names are so-and-so, client so-and-so, so-and-so. Yeah, I think already I discussed this. At the data element level, we can maintain the field labels now. We'll have four types of labels: short label, medium label, long and what? Heading. Long and what? Heading. So for MANDT, which label it is trying to pick? Medium, it seems. No problem. For employee ID also, it is picking which label? Medium label. If you want to pick short label, choose what? Short label. Like this, we can choose my own labels. We can choose my own labels. Yeah, good. Yeah, you can observe here for MANDT, we have short, medium, long, and heading. For EMPID, you can see we have short, none. If you don't want any label, I can choose none. We are short and medium, but I don't have what? Long and heading. Probably I might have not maintained it. Let me cancel and check. I'll just cancel this. I'll just save and go back and check the table. So if you go to SC11, ZABAP underscore team, if you double click on the data element MANDT, okay, at the data element level for this field, if I go to field label, Yes, all the four labels are maintained. If I go back, if I double click on my data element EMP ID, only what short label and what medium label is maintained. That's why these two are grayed out there. And if you take employee name, nothing is maintained. For employee name, nothing is maintained. So keep this in mind. So let me go back to the screen layout. I'll go to the layout. So I have to design three database fields. So choose, go to secondary window, provide the table name, click on get from dictionary. I got it, right? So for employee name, none is selected because I have not maintained any label. And what is the control it is choosing by default, whether you want to create this control as a text field or whether you want to create this as what, checkbox or what, readable. By default it is text, it seems. Let me select all the things. I can select individually like this, or I can just click on this. Since I want all, I'm selecting that, click on continue. Yeah, you can see now I can place it wherever I want. I'll place it here, done. Okay, so it has designed that. So these labels are picked from what, data element level. For this one, there is no label because I have not maintained any label for that particular data element. That's the reason. That's the reason it is always recommended to maintain field labels at the data element level, so that wherever that field is referred, in whichever screen that field is referred, it will pick the data, it will pick the label from the data element level. Okay, so let me align it properly. I'll just click and drop it right hand side, done. So you can see here, if you want to maintain label, you can maintain. So see this, we have three input fields and we have what, two labels here, two text fields. So if I double click on this client, yeah, what is the type of element? Element type is what, text field. What is the name it has proposed? Zabap underscore team hyphen mandt. If I double click on this input field, if I double click on this, yeah, what is this, input output field, input output field, the name is so and so, done. And this is employee ID. Okay, so names are proposed based on your dictionary field names. Dictionary structure name hyphen field name, dictionary structure name hyphen field name, done. I want a label for this. If you want, you can maintain. So I'll choose what, text field here. I'll just draw it here. Okay, what happened? Yeah, okay, double click on this. I'll give the name, I'll give the name as something T1. I'll give the text as what, EMP name. So whatever I want, I can give it, done. Then I want one exit button. So on the toolbox, I'll take a button. I'll draw it here, done. I have to set some pink color indicates. We have not set the name. So I'll double click on this. I'll give the name as something B1. Text what you want to give. I'll give it as exit. I'll give it as exit. And every button should have a function code. Now, how do you attach function code in our reports? User command. User command. Here you can see there's a property called as FCT code, function code. You can give any function code. Let me give it as FC1. That's all. So for the button, what are the minimum properties, name and what, function code. After giving the function code only, the color has been changed. Okay, so the function code of this button is what, FC1, done. Let me save it. Check for the syntax errors, activate this. Done, it is activated. Right, it is activated. Done, done. So before I continue, any questions, please? Okay, if there are no questions, done. I'll just save it, check for the syntax, activate this. I'm activating the screen, it's activated. Come back to your this. Done. So what I did so far, I came to SCAT, I created a module program, then I right clicked on the and that module program I have created with top include, then I right clicked on the program, I have created a screen. What type of screen? Normal screen. On that screen layout, I have placed the fields. I have placed the fields from what, one of my dictionary structure. What is the dictionary structure? Z test underscore or Z abap underscore team. I took what, three fields, and automatically the labels are coming from what, data element level, if they are maintained. Done. Let me execute this program. I'll right click on this. Okay, you need to activate first. Now right click on this, I'll say activate. Done, it is activated. Okay, it is activated, done. Now I need to execute now. So how do we execute our report programs? By pressing what? F8. By pressing F8. So I can here, I'll right click on the program, right click on the program, execute direct processing. This is the way you have to execute. Right click on the program, execute direct processing. So when I execute, I am getting an error on the status bar. Please choose an executable object. It is asking me to select what? Executable object, it seems. Okay, so what you have to understand is module put programs cannot be executed directly. Okay, it requires T code. It requires what? Transaction code. So compulsorily we have to create the T code for what? Module put program. Then only we can execute that. So how do we create the T codes? Where do we create the T codes? SC93. Already we have seen creating our own T codes for table maintenance. So here also I can go to SC93. I can create the T code. So instead of going to SC93, I'll right click on the program. I'll say create transaction. Right click on the program and say create transaction. It takes a control to what? SC93 only. So I'll just choose, right click on the program, create transaction. Right. It is asking me the T code. It is asking me the transaction code. I'll give the T code as something Z. Okay, start with Z. I'll give the name as something ZTP or ZTM. ZTM. Done. Short text. I'll just give the short text T code for what? MPP. So if you are creating the T code for a table maintenance, we have to choose what? Transaction with parameters. If you are creating the T code for your executable program, report program, we'll choose what? Program and what? Selection screen. And selection screen number is always what? 1000. Whenever you are creating the T code for a module program, choose the first radio button. What is that? Program and what? Screen. Program and screen, continue. Okay, I'll continue. Done. Okay, so here you can see it is asking me the program name. What is my program name? ZTestMPP. So I'll just give the program name ZTestMPP. Then it is asking the screen number. What is the screen number here? 100. So if I can type 100, or if you browse also, it will show that. Yeah, we have what? 100. Here also we have the concept of authorization object. So in next couple of days, we'll see how to create our own authorization object. We require it for table maintenance also. Okay, so just leave it. I'm just giving the data for mandatory fields. Program name I'm giving, screen number I'm giving. And whenever you create the T code, you must select the checkbox what? SAP GA for Windows. So let me select the checkbox SAP GA for Windows. Just save it. T code is also getting saved separately. Check for the syntax errors. No errors. Now you can run the T code. What is the T code? ZTM, or you can right click on the program, say execute direct processing. Earlier when I have chosen this navigation before creating the T code, I am getting an error. Please choose an executable object. Now we have created the T code. So when I say create execute direct processing, then I got the screen. One second, please. Yeah, done. So I got the screen, right? So now you can see here, I don't have any back button. Whenever we create our own screen, the back button will be disabled. So I need to enable that. How do we enable that? We have to define our own GUI status. Already we discussed how to define our own GUI status by using the statement set PF status. So again, at that point, I'll cover later on, not required for this requirement. I'll just ignore it. If I click on exit also, I cannot exit. So you need to write the logic for that particular button. So let me cancel this. How do you cancel? /n. Done. Okay, so let me go back to the program SC80. So what is my requirement now? I have to write the logic for what? Button. Okay, I tried the logic for the button. If the button is there on selection screen, and if you click on selection screen button, what is the first event triggered at selection screen? At selection screen. But this is a module pool program, na? So the event triggered is PAI, process after input. So I need to handle an event called as what? Process after input. So where do we handle the events in our report programs? At the end of the program, na? At the end of the program, we'll handle the events one after the other. Here, in case of dialog programming, in case of module pool programming, you can see here. Yeah, here, what is my requirement now? I need to write the logic for what? Push button, module pool push button. What is the event triggered? PAI, process after input. So where do we handle the events? Means if you go to the screen, if you double click on the screen, right? So it is in display mode. It is in display mode. I'll switch to editable mode. Done. So already we have seen attributes tab. In the attributes tab, we gave the description and we are choosing the screen type as what? Normal. Now, and already we have seen the layout. And if you see the element list contains what? It contains information about screen elements. On my screen, what I took three text fields, three IO fields, and one button. All those information will be available in what? Element list tab. If I go to element list tab, you can see here, it is showing me the names of your screen fields. It is showing me the type of the element. Okay, one is text field, another is IO field, all the what coordinates where that element is available. Right, this is not much of use to us, so just leave it. So attributes is over, layout is over, element list is what? It contains all the screen elements information. Now, in order to handle the event, go to what? Flow logic. Okay, in the flow logic, you can see there are two events. These two are called events, PBO event and what? PAI event, process before output and process after what? Input. So let me go to PAI, process after input. Okay, so I'll go to PAI, process after input. Yeah, inside this event. Okay, inside this PAI event, process after input, there is one module. So if it is a report program, how do we handle at the end of the program, you'll say what? At selection screen. Okay, you'll write some logic. If you want one more event, you'll handle that event. Okay, so events will handle it at the end of the program. Initialization event, and you'll write the logic for that. Okay, similarly here, in case of module pool, what is the event triggered when you click on the button PA, process after input? Every event in module pool will be associated with one or more modules. So by default, one module is available here. It is disabled. Okay, so let me enable it. So what is the purpose of this module? Inside this module definition only, we will write the business logic of the events. In our reports, we used to handle the events at the end of the program and write the logic. Here, the business logic related to the events should be written inside what? Module definition. So this is a module proposed by what? SAP itself. If you want to use it, what you have to do? Uncomment it and use it. Or else you can create our own module. You can say module followed by what? Module name. Like this, I can create my own module. Let me make use of this module given by SAP itself. So this is a module name. If you want, you can change the name, otherwise leave it. Let me double click on this. I have to write the logic for the module definition. So double click on that. I'm getting a message. PA module does not exist. Create. Yes. I'll choose what? Acha. It is asking where you want to write this module definition. Whether you want SAP to create a new include program, whether you want to write that in the main program, or whether you want to write that inside what? Subroutine? Sorry. Whether you want to write that inside what? Top include program. Okay. I can go for a new include program, or I can write it in the main program, or I can go for a top include program. So better to go for what? Top include. Already I told, we can use a top include program for declaring global variables, subroutine definitions, and module definitions. Okay. So let me choose this top include program. It is not compulsory that I have to choose this only. I can choose any of the thing. but I am trying to follow the standards. Okay, so I'll choose top include, I'll continue. Done. Do you want to save? Yes. So it has taken the control to a top include program. What is the signature of the definition? Module and what? End module, just like form, end form, just like function, end function, method, end method. We have what? Module and what? End module. Write the logic here. Already we know the logic now. What is that? The function code is captured in what? Psi ucom, case psi ucom. When FC1 leave program, save it, check for the syntax error, activate this. Then it is activated. Okay, so my top include program is activated. So let me go back, F3. Activate everything. This flow logic is what? Inactive. Activate this. Done. So what we are trying to understand here, whenever we click on the module pull push buttons, what is the event triggered? PAI, process after input. So in this flow logic section, I have uncommented the module for the PAI event. I wrote the module definition inside my top include program. Activate everything. Activate your top include. Activate your flow logic. Activate your program also. Right click on the program and say what? Activate. Done. It is activated. Let me try to execute now. Right click on this. Execute direct processing. Then I got the screen. If I click on the button, what is the event triggered? And what is the event triggered? PAI, process after input. So again, this is important. We should not blindly give the answers in the interview. What is the event triggered when you click on the button means? We should ask whether it is a selection screen, whether it is a module pull, whether it is a ALV report using function model or using classes. In different areas, different event will be what? Triggered. In selection screen, the event triggered is what? At selection screen. In case of module pull, the event triggered is what? PAI, process after input. So as part of the PAI module definition only, we have implemented the business logic. So done. I'll click on this. Yes, working fine. We are able to execute. So what is my next requirement now? I'm able to design the screen. I'm able to write the logic for what? Back button, exit button. Done. Now employee ID. So see here, when I press F4, what is the message I'm getting? No input help is what? Available. So if you go back to that particular table, at the data element level, do any search help attached? If you double click on this, there is no search help attached at what? Data element level. If there is any search help attached at the data element level, it would have appeared. It would have appeared on the screen. Okay, so since it is not available at the data element level, I need to associate that manually. How do we associate? See, go back to the screen properties. If we go to layout, right, so done. So now for this employee ID, I have to attach the search help. Sorry, first of all, I should know what search help I have to attach. What is the search help we created in the last class? ZENM_ESP1. This is the search help I want to attach. ZENM_ESP1. So what I'll do here, go back to your layout. Done. So double click on this employee ID, double click on the employee ID, and you can see here, somewhere you can see in the property window, yeah, you can see there's a property called as search help. In the property window for this input field, I double clicked on the input field, it has opened that IO field. There's a property called as search help. Let me attach that. What is that? ZENM_ESP1. I can attach elementary search help, or I can attach what? Collective search help. Anything is fine, right? So I'll press enter. Done. Search help will be attached. Now it is good. You can see here in the design time only, I'm able to see the icon now. Okay, so let me save it. Check for the syntax error. Activate this. Right, it is activated. Done, done, done. Let me go back. Let me activate this. That's all over. So right click on this, activate and execute. Yeah, you can see now I'll press F4. The search help is what attached. So I'll choose something like this. I got the data. I got the data. Oh, what is that? Ha 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 ha. Oh, array. I'm sorry, boss. Sorry, I'm still sorry. Yesterday I created the search help for which one? Employee name now. Employee name is a character. Okay, but how can you attach to this numeric field? That's why it is giving what? Enter a numeric field. Good, good, good that we got the error. So this is nothing but called as automatic field validation. Automatically it is validating depending on the data type. Employee ID is expecting what? Numeric values. But you attach the search help, which is going to return me what? Characters. So let me just exit. Acha. See, I cannot exit now. I cannot exit now. So going forward, we'll take one button called as cancel button to do the forceful exit. As of now, I'll just remove this. Now I'll click on exit. Okay, done. So I have to attach it to what? Employee name now. So I'll go back to what? This one. I'll remove it from here. I'll attach it to employee name. Acha, for employee name also, we'll not get any search help by default. So if you execute this once again, right, I'll press F4, not available. So let me attach now. How do you attach? Go to the layout, double click on this search help. What is the search help name? ZENM_ESP1. ZENM_ESP1, done. That's it. Okay, it is attached. Now when I execute, activate this. Right, so I'll press F4. I got the values. Done, working fine. So we understood how to attach the search help at what data, transaction level also. And what is the other requirement I told here? Client field should be disabled. Actually, anyhow, by default it is disabled. When I execute this, by default it is disabled only. My default is disabled. I don't want the client field. Actually, I want to enable it. How do we enable it here? By default it is disabled. Let me check whether I can enable or not. I'll go to layout. Let me double click on the client field. Yeah, if you double click on the client field, you can see we have a display tab here. I'll go to display tab. Okay, I'll go to program tab. Yeah, I'll go to program tab. You can see here, there is one checkbox selected here. What is this here? Output field. Only this is selected. Okay, so I'll just choose what? Input field. Okay, I'm choosing it as what? Input field. Select the checkbox what? Input field, done. Let me save it, check for the syntax, activate this. Go back. When I execute, it is enabled, I can give the values. Okay, so I just started the introduction of what module to programming, but before we discuss full-fledged module program, we need to discuss other concepts in dictionary objects. Still, we have a few more things like currency, quantity fields, buffering, types of database tables. Okay, I'll discuss those things, then I'll come to what module program. But why I discussed today is just to understand that we can attack the search help at what transaction level only. Anyhow, we understood the entire process. By using the screen painter tool, we have created the screen and we understood that whenever we want the database fields, instead of designing them manually, I can directly design them referring to a database structure. Okay, and we understood that we cannot directly execute the module program. It requires what? T code. So we have seen how to create the T code for what? Module pool program. Okay, and we also understood that whenever we go for our own screens, SAP will lose the functionality of what? Back button. We need to enable it. But as of now, we have handled what? Yeah, is it audible? I'm having some voice issue. Is it audible now? Okay, yeah, some issue is there. Done. So we understood how to design the screen and how to attach the search help to the what, so and so. More about the module program we'll discuss after 4 or 5 days after completing what, dictionary objects, right? And in search help only, I have not yet discussed about what. There is an important thing like what? Yeah, search help exit. I have not discussed. This is also very important. Okay, search help exit. Okay, so this will come under announcements. So when we go to that, we'll see that search help exit. Yeah, search help exit is a function model for making the input help process discover. Okay, so you'll not understand now. Just ignore that. Yes, so voice is breaking. Okay, there is some issue with the audio connection. Yeah, is it audible now? Hello? Yeah, I'm having some network issues. Okay, so I'll just wind off the session. We'll continue tomorrow. I'm having some network issues. Is it audible to everyone?